the lifeblood of rock and roll music. The guitar is for many as iconic an American symbol as the Stars and Stripes or apple pie. Enter Elliot Michael, a well-schooled musician. He's become a renowned collector, curator of fine instruments, and the first person many top artists look to when they are in need of a special guitar. Today, we're lucky enough to get the full story on some of these beauties as we explore Rumble Seat music.
When I first started the store, I was trying to come up with a name, and you know, you come up with Michael's Music, this, that, that, you know, just nothing sounded right. I like old cars, so I was thinking like an old Rumble Seat, and like I was married to this woman, you know, when I first started. So I said to her, "What do you think about the name?" She said, "I hate it." I went, "Perfect." So I kept it. A lot of people that I've been dealing with for a long time have collections, and they'll call us and they want to sell a couple of their guitars, or original owners will call us because they've heard about us and we'll end up buying guitars from them. Rumble Seat is a special place because people can actually come in from off the streets and be able to look around and see like all these really beautiful high-end guitars and actually play them, which is definitely different than most stores that I've experienced. I love it when people, you know, come in and sit down and play like a 59 Les Paul and just go, "Wow, this is the best guitar I've ever played." And it's just the fact that sometimes we'll have kids who are like 12 years old, 10-year-old kids come in and go, and they'll point to the 59 Les Paul and they go, "Is that the same guitar that Jimmy Page plays and that Jeff Beck played and all those people?" And we'll say, "Yeah," and then we give them the guitar to play, and you can see the smile on their face. They're just really happy, you know, they actually play the guitar like that. Most of the rock stars I know that deal with us are just really great people, really easy to deal with, and they know what they want. So it's just a matter of them calling us and us shipping them guitars. Or sometimes, last year Johnny Depp came into a store in Albuquerque and ended up buying a bunch of guitars and bought a couple of guitars for the guys in Aerosmith. So it's just easy to deal with. The store in New York is a bigger store. It's two floors, a very cool old building. It's a great store. The store in Carmel, I came out here just to visit a friend and ended up staying here and then opened a store. And we opened up more of a boutique-y, smaller store here.
Good friend Joe Bonamassa has been known to make an appearance in Rumble Seat.
I've known Joe since he was 12. And we've always been friends, and I knew his father, and we used to do guitar shows together and hang out together a lot. Now Joe has become the virtuoso he is. So Joe and I go back 25, something like that, years now. We deal with the Rolling Stones, we deal with U2, we deal with Rush is another band we deal with. Well, Joe Bonamassa, like I said before, Brian Setzer is a really good friend of mine. Again, the list goes on. There's a lot of people that we deal with. We have something for almost every collector and player. You know, there's every level of expensive guitars to down to reasonable price guitars.
If you're looking for the cream of the crop, follow Elliot down the hall to what was once a bank vault.
Every guitar that's high end goes into the vault at nighttime and comes back out in the morning.
Should your axe fall on dark days, it's a full-service shop. Elliot and his mates can perform guitar and equipment maintenance and repairs of any kind. The former owners of these instruments reads like a who's who of music legends past and present. Take a strum through Elliot's inventory, and you inevitably end up with pieces of rock history in your hands.
Purple Marshall is a limited edition Jimi Hendrix edition. A friend of mine in Italy had the largest collection of Marshall amps. And what I did is I went over there a few years ago and bought every Marshall he had. So we had the largest Marshall collection around. So that's one of the ones I've kept. That's one of my favorites. That's the late 60s Marshall stack, which is the ultimate amplifier to me. You know, it's what everybody used back in the late 60s, the 70s, and still using them now.
Connecting musicians from all corners of the globe, Elliot unites the creative community through his passion for these instruments and their musical potential.
If you have a guitar that's all original, that's the best way to keep it, whether it's in great condition, bad condition, just always keep it original, because if you do any changes, it's like anything that's collectible. it brings the value down. So people take a guitar because it's got a scratch, they'll have it refinished. And what that'll do is it can bring the price down half what it's valued at. So the best thing to do, if you have a guitar and it's a vintage guitar that you really care about, just let it be, and it's keep it original. A lot of guitar players are striving to get a 59 Les Paul. The problem is they are expensive and they are hard to find. You know, all the original ones are really hard to find because they've been around for so long, people have done changes to them, and you just never know until you have it in your hands if it's original or not. If you've ever tried one, you'd understand it. If you haven't, you know, we'd love to come by and try one.
Thanks to Elliot and Rumble Seat Music, you can visit these rare gems today. And if the chemistry and price is right, start your own musical adventure.